Welcome to My Conversation, a presentation of KAIL-TV, My Central Valley. So let's get My Conversation started.
Hello, good morning. Welcome to a brand new episode of My Conversation right here on KAIL-TV, My Central Valley. Austin Reed back with you. Long time no see. Thank you so much for hanging out with us this morning. Of course, it is Memorial Day, and from all of us here at KAIL-TV, we want to honor our fallen men and women, and obviously thank you to all our veterans as well here across the United States of America. All right, we have another great show for you today. Of course, you see My Conversation weekdays 10 to 10:30 right after Access Hollywood Live. Coming up, we're going to be talking to Keith Allen from Friday Night In. So make sure you stay with us for the next 30 minutes. My studio audience this morning, give it up for Keith Allen in the house. He's kicking this show off today and this morning on this Memorial Day. Keith, good to meet you.
Good to meet you too.
Thank you so much for coming in. So Friday Night In, for our viewers out there that haven't heard about what Friday Night In is, go into detail for us.
Okay. Friday Night In is a concept that I came up with that I just recently launched and still in the process of launching.
Okay.
But what it allows people to do is go through and explore and enjoy the dining experience at home versus going out to, say, like a restaurant, you know. Whether it's, you know, instead of like, you know, I want to, you know, let's go through and let's stay in, that type of thing. And it's just like, hey, you know what? You know, if they go on ahead and make advanced plans and give me a call, what I can do is that I'll design a menu, you know, whether it's for a party of two or four or eight or, you know, 10, that type of thing. Or,
sure.
And either go to their home. Or if they want, they can come and dine at my home with the chef.
Nice.
Yes.
How long
yeah.
have you been a chef for?
Longer than I care to mention. Actually, I got started in the restaurant business in high school and,
okay.
and all the way through college. I used to be one of the chefs at the old Nicola's restaurant here in town that used to be located at Shields and Maroa, home of the stuffed steak. So
wow.
yes.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah.
What. Have you, so you've always been a food lover.
Food lover, foodie, foodaholic, yeah, you name it,
yeah.
you name it. So, but no, it's been a huge passion. It's very passionate. You know, you can treat designing dishes and making dishes of food, you know, it's kind of like artwork, you know, you're
sure.
going through and you're creating like an individual piece of, you know, of art, you know,
mm-hmm.
however the food might be plated or the, you know, the... creating something just absolutely new, you know, just kind of like, well, where'd that come from? It's just like, I don't know.
it just happened.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, when inspiration hits and then, you know, take notes and, you know, create it. And
we're looking at the picture now. What uh-huh. is this?
That's a pork tenderloin.
Oh.
Yeah, seated on a bed of lettuce with broiled vegetables. So yeah, that was one for an event that I did. It was actually, it's stuffed, but it was trussed up. I went through and it was rolled up like a roulade is what it is. Roulade means to roll. And so it was tied and anyway, pulled out and yeah, sorry, it was,
yeah.
you know, sliced and it all went. But what I do with a lot of the dishes is that I pair them with wine, you know, where
you were telling me that earlier
yeah,
before
so,
the show. Yeah.
So my things that I do are the food and wine pairings, you know, that, yeah, that's another meat dish and with a very bold Cabernet right there.
And so with the wines, You pick wines from all across the world.
I do. You know, it's the way I look at it, it's a great big world. You know, so many people get so focused with whether it's Napa wines or wines from Sonoma, you know, or you got Anderson Valley. But, you know, there's tons of other places.
Outside of California.
Well, exactly. You have Willamette, you know, in Oregon.
Yep, I know that well.
You know, there's South African, you know, Pinotages that you can go through and use. And And I had traveled to South America on a trip down through Peru and experienced a lot of, you know, different wine varietals on a vacation I was down there, especially coming out of the Mendoza region in Argentina. So I've used some Argentinian, you know, Malbecs, and even their cabs have just phenomenal. You know, the soil content changes just the flavor and the complexity of the wine. So, yeah.
So between traveling and your chef expertise, I mean, that's really the reason behind Friday Night In.
It is to go through to, you know, it's to share it, you know, just the love of food and the love of wine, which people do, you know, it's like I said, it's a great big world. And I mean, there's tons of places that you can go through and find, you know, different wines from. And, you know, what's really interesting is you don't have to have the, you know, you may have a magnificent dish to create, but you don't have to have, you know, a $60, $80 bottle of wine. You know, you can have an excellent wine for $15 or $10, or sometimes you can stumble across just a sleeper, as we call them.
You know,
yeah, whether you're at one of the stores around here and just like, hey, check this out, you know. It
it's
has
like
a cool label.
Bucks.
A lot of times, like, hey, this is a cool label. And,
yeah.
and a lot of times, the cool label, you know, it turns out
and
to be
pretty
a real,
good.
Exactly.
Okay, here's a question. Vegetarian, like if somebody is maybe a vegetarian and maybe they don't drink, can you still do?
Oh, sure. Oh, definitely.
An event? Okay.
Yeah, you know, if they
private
want,
event.
Exactly. Whatever that, you know, whatever that the people who hire me for, you know, for that service, yeah, I work with them on whatever type of menu, even if it's going to be gluten-free.
Sure, that too.
You know, so, you know, you do run into that also. But yeah, but a lot of the times a lot of the dishes are more very old world. Is how I was taught and trained on the line. Yeah.
Wow, it's amazing. This Friday Night In is very, very exciting.
Yeah, it's spelled I-N-N for it because it's again, you know, it's just like, hey, you know, let's go through and have a Friday Night In or you know that type of thing. And I'll even bring in
My mouth is
that's actually crostinis with olive tapenade.
Oh.
And the other one is a brined peppers with a salmon mousse that I did.
Salmon mousse. Oh
yes.
My goodness.
Yes.
It is art. It is art.
Keith. It is. Yeah. It is. That was for an event I did last June.
We've got about 30 seconds left. Can you tell, you know, if somebody wants to connect with you, they want you to come to their house or they want to come to your house for this private experience, private dining, how can they connect with you? How can they contact you?
Well, you can go through and reach me at, you can email me at manos.day.oro@aol.com or my phone number is 559-287-5845. And the way Manos came about is we were sitting around cooking and whatever, and a friend of mine went through and he's just like, you got hands of gold, you're Manos. And I'm like, oh my God.
Perfectly. Sorry. And you kept with it.
Yeah, you did, yeah. It's kind of like Sting. Nobody calls him Gordon, they call him Sting.
They
so
yeah,
around my
Sting.
Household, just Manos. I'm like, great.
It works. Keith, thank you so much for talking about Friday Night. And
you got
stay
it.
Right here, though,
all
because
right.
on the other side of the break, you've got something else. That you're doing that we want to talk about here on My Conversation. So stay right there. And you stay right there as well. You're watching My Conversation right here on KAIL-TV. We'll be back with Keith Allen in just a couple of minutes. Hey, welcome back. Good morning, everybody. This is My Conversation right here on KAIL-TV, over the air, channel 7.1, cable 13, satellite 53. Austin Reed with you on this Memorial Day. Hope you're having a great morning so far. And if you're off work, I hope you're enjoying it. And of course, from all of us here at KAIL, we want to remember our fallen heroes today. All right, we are continuing our conversation this morning with Keith Allen from Friday Night In. My studio audience, give him another round of applause. You know, earlier we were talking about, of course, Friday Night In. And real quick, for our viewers that are just tuning in, give a 30-second synopsis of what Friday Night In is.
Friday Night In is that if you want to have the restaurant experience brought to your home, Contact me and I can go through and do that. I can design a menu if you want steaks, seafood, whatever it might be, and show up and even have a proper table setting.
Proper table setting. So a nice, calm, private experience with food that's art, paired up with wine or other drinks of anyone's choice. And
exactly.
and you cater it, whether it's vegetarian, gluten-free, or a steak. You've got them. Hey, another thing that you're doing too, on top of your chef experience, is United Cerebral Palsy.
Yeah.
And this is a fundraiser. Go into more detail on what this is that you're working with now.
United Cerebral Palsy of Central California has been very near and dear to my heart. That sounds pretty cliché, but it really has. The students, that's what they like to be called. They're students, the people who attend the programs there. They are my friends. I'd like to be able to, you know, see more things happen for them, and that's why generating a fundraising event like what I did has been slowly taking off, and it's starting to gain a lot more exposure. It's more perpetual. I mean, who doesn't like, you know, food and wine and, you know, basically be treated like
a king and queen.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly, you know, there. I had created, it's called Pulling Strings because it takes a lot of us to put it together. We have to pull a lot of strings, and also the love of music. Because one of my philosophies is like cooking is like jazz. You know, you do have to improv. And almost immediately things will go through and change, whether the heat's different or something it's just like, okay, well, this is going to have to go this direction, you know? A lot of people that are jazz
lovers. It's just like with a guitar.
Exactly.
Or drums.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, so it's the same thing, you know, with the food. It's four courses, and each course has a separate pairing that's with it. And the menu that I have is the stuffed steak from the old Nicola's restaurant where I used to work.
Yeah, we were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, and then also I have the my own dish, which is a stuffed salmon, which is also on the menu. And then I have an old family recipe, so I do homemade raviolis.
Ooh.
Yeah, they're all handmade and with a puttanesca sauce, a tomato sauce that's included with it. And then the dessert. You know, it kind of varies on what the dessert might be, you know. One year I had baked pears with honey ice cream and, you know, a little sugar medallion.
Never heard of that.
Yeah, just some fun things and with a current reduction with currants and stuff. But a lot of the produce and everything I use, it's all done here locally.
Oh, sweet.
And
okay.
So all the funds that's generated off of, not to digress back into the food portion of it, but everything that comes off of that goes directly back to the center to help with whether it's supplies, you know, art supplies, or for their multimedia that they do. You know, they do, whether it's, you know, a lot of plays or the type of things that they do, the students are actually starting to create and sell a lot of the objects that they are making. So it's just fantastic, you know, what the center has to offer.
And tell everybody what the disease is.
You know, it's not a disease.
Not a disease.
It's not a disease.
And
what they do is that they handle a lot of folks maybe, you know, however that they, you know, if they're born with it. They also deal with autism.
Okay.
So,
okay.
You know, they offer programs that are there to help, you know, families with that. Also to maybe point in a direction for, you know, it's pretty difficult with a lot of folks that have children, whether it's, when I say children, whether they're kids or adults, because they're still their kids, because they're still taking care of them, you know, they need respite. They need to be able to take a break, you know?
Okay.
So the center's there also to help them, you know, direct them in that direction too.
So the event, you've got the event that's coming up August 26th?
It is. It's August 26th at the Falls Event Center on the end of, I think it's Bullard over there.
Okay.
Yeah, new location this year. And ton of fun. Live music.
Nice.
Oh yeah. Always have to. Music. I always have to have live music. I always music said if I food. Had a restaurant, yeah, it's going to have live jazz music, and that's what we have.
What website, phone number? How can people connect with you if they want to get involved with this event coming up this summer?
If you want to buy tickets, get on the website ccucp.org. That goes directly to United Cerebral Palsy. There should be a link there, and that'll be coming up shortly. So if you want to go through and buy tickets, two pulling strings. And all the information and the menu will be uploaded here soon.
Keith Allen from Friday Night In, and of course the United Cerebral
Palsy.
Cerebral Palsy. I'm so sorry. Cerebral Palsy. Give him a nice round of applause. Great information. Thank you for coming on today and talking about everything that you're doing. A pleasure to meet you.
You got it.
Come on back on again and update us about the everything that you got going on.
You got it. Hopefully you can come.
Yes, I would love to.
All right.
This summer.
All right.
Thank you, Keith. Hey, thanks for watching My Conversation. We'll be right back.